The teams you have selected and the states you have shortlisted are also the markets which television numbers from Asian Games and Olympics show are among the more viewed markets. So to me, that has got all the makings of a success story here, and we're clearly looking forward to it.
Fabulous. Absolutely fabulous. So you've heard from all the architects of this league, the people who have put it together from television, from FIBB, from the BFI, and from baseline. So gentlemen, I'll give you one quick photo opportunity with all these gentlemen. If you want one-on-ones with them later, that's not a problem. We'll organize one-on-ones with them afterwards. But right now, we'll just say thank you to them for one last picture. And after that, what I want to do is start with the next part of it, which is announcing the six important teams out here. So gentlemen, for one last time. I'm probably going to invite you back at the end for another photo opportunity with our team owners. But now it's time for, which everyone's waiting for. Till now we know everything that's happened. Now it's a big one. Who are the six teams out here? And let me announce them one by one. If you want to know what the order is, we thought a lot about what kind of order we can go for. And we finally decided the easiest way to do this is alphabetical order. So alphabetical order it is, and we start with our first team right down from the west. You know, it's a hotbed of sport in many other sports, but it's coming out. The Ahmedabad Defenders from the city of Ahmedabad. May I invite Mr. Chaudhary on stage with the Ahmedabad Defenders. From then, we move down. Where do you go from A? There's nobody in B, but we have somebody in C. And all the way, it's a hotbed of volleyball from the city from Kerala. The Calicut Heroes. Mr. Safi from the Calicut Heroes. And we are still down south in another center down south, which is really big. And knowing the team names you're going to make out, they're going to make a real fight of this league. We were due to have Mr. Sivaprakasam out here, but he's not managed to make it. But from the Kals group, we have Upili representing the Chennai Spartans. Chennai. Ladies and gentlemen. So Ahmedabad, Calicut, Chennai. Where are we going from here? We are now closer to the center of the country, and they have a team name that is a bit scary. The other teams will be looking at it. They call themselves the Black Hawks, and they're from Hyderabad. Shyam Gopu from Agile. The Hyderabad Black Hawks. Where can we go from there? From there, we remain in the south for a very, very special team. It's somebody, it's a person who's been involved with sport and a lover of sport throughout. The Kochi Blue Spikers, represented here by Thomas Muthoot. Come on. And finally, we were wondering which other city to have, but where can you have somebody who has more knowledge of sport than this group and this person? And somebody representing a city which is known for its love of sport, all the way right their hometown out here, Mr. Ronnie Screwvala for U Mumbai. So that, gentlemen, is your six teams out here. The Ahmedabad Defenders, the Calicut Heroes, the Chennai Spartans, the Hyderabad Black Hawks, Hyderabad as they call it. He's worn a black t-shirt for a shirt for that. The Kochi Blue Spikers, and of course, U Mumbai Volley, which is fantastic. That's the extension of their U Mumbai franchise, which has been so successful in Kavati. Gentlemen, take your seats. We're going to ask you a couple of questions to all of you. And then I'll open it up for the audience for three or four questions. And then after that, you can have one-on-ones as well. Gentlemen, I'll start with you, Chaudhary Saab. Chaudhary Saab, you've been really, Mr. Chaudhary from his group has been a part of the Special Olympics. See, one thing you'll note about all the owners out here, either they come from two places, either a passion and understanding of sport or a passion and understanding of volleyball. For Mr. Chaudhary, it's the first, a passion and understanding of sport. He has been a veteran of the Special Olympics. He's one of the most awarded people in the country of helping special needs people get an opportunity. Sir, why have you chosen volleyball to come on volleyball?
Basically, my parents बेसिकली मैंने 30 साल वॉलंटियरी वर्क किया स्पेशल ओलंपिक्स में जो इंटेलेक्चुअल डिसेबल्ड चिल्ड्रन एंड एडल्ट्स हैं उनके लिए. गवर्नमेंट ऑफ गुजरात और काफ़ी लोग बोल रहे थे चौधरी साहब आप नॉर्मल में भी काम कीजिए, तो ना मैंने अभी 10 साल आने वाले जो 10 साल हैं वो ओनली फॉर बेसिकली वॉलीबॉल के लिए मैंने पसंद किए हैं. और मेरा एम है 2020-24-28 ओलंपिक्स में इंडिया की अच्छे से अच्छी टीम खेले और मेडल लाए. उसके लिए मैंने मेरे 10 साल वॉलीबॉल के लिए निकाले.
थैंक यू सो मच चौधरी साहब. The man sitting next to him, Mr. Safi, let me tell you a story about him. They run, you know, one of India's most successful volleyball websites. So we went to meet them to, you know, understand the sport. And they said, you know, if you're actually doing a sport, why can't we get a team? So I looked at him and said, how old are you? And I said, I may not be old enough, but I think when you know a little bit more about our company, you'll understand why we want to be there. So Safi is the one person I've seen where we met in a meeting in Kochi. And he was driving back to Calicut. And on the way back, he's got the GPS locations of 3 volleyball courts in which he can play games on the way back. You know, that's the kind of passion is there, Safir. Safir, Calicut, you must be really happy. Is Calicut really a big city for volleyball?
Of course. As you know, Calicut itself is known as the city of volleyball in India, which holds the maximum number of volleyball fans. And with our team also, we are really a bunch of really crazy volley lovers. And we were in the volleyball industry for past 8 to 9 years. And of course, all these big legends of Indian volleyball would have participated for our team also. And our team too have a real vision on the sports, like that all the private entities should keep a place for all the sports section. And proud to say that we are the only one private section which holds a department volleyball team in India. And so proud to be that, and hope our city, Calicut itself, can do much more things in pro volleyball.
Fabulous, you know, that's real passion coming through for the sport. Upili sir, the Chennai Spartans, the Carls group have been involved in volleyball for a very long time.
Exactly, it is a, if I will say, it's a 4-decade story. Okay. All the promoters, they love volleyball. So volleyball is there in the blood, and it's somehow, it's a DNA of the complete promoter family. That basically brings us here, number one. Number two, I was just connecting to all the vision that has been given to the architects. And Carl's group's vision has been, one is passion and commitment, which is always there, which drives the DNA of the organization all these while. Second is connecting to rural India. As an organization, we always believe in increasing the capability of the human resources. Okay, be it the organization, be it the society, be it the community. So this is one opportunity where we see we can connect the rural community, unleash their potential, unlock their capability, and bring them to the limelight. Okay, we see this as more of like a corporate social endeavor, okay, which is also one of the passion of Carl's group. And secondly, yes, taking the sport, the league of the sport, which has been known across India, which is one of the most viewed sport, but somehow it has not been given the attention of what it is expected to be given. Taking the sport to the next league, taking it global. Okay. So spirit, spark, that gives a spark. Okay. Because Sparta is a place we all know, which is very much attached to the history of First World War. Okay. So we would like to fight, we would like to take the sport globally, we would like to unlock the potential, increase the human capability, and take the sport league ahead.
Okay, he's up for a fight, so the other teams. And before I introduce Sham, I'd like to say the Blackhawks Hyderabad are the only team who can with confidence say that one of their players is in the promo of that you see, the advertisement. Of course, the reason they can say that is not because they've cheated or they're anyone in the league, but because they also own a badminton team whose star player is PV Sindhu, who, if you don't know, is a daughter of volleyball. Her father was an Arjuna awardee in volleyball. Her mother was from the family of volleyball, so she says that I'm a girl of volleyball, I'm from the volleyball family. And when we went out then said that, you know, can you just appear and, you know, be a part of this, she said, anytime. So you're the only one who has Sindhu, but wonderful from badminton coming to volleyball. How does it feel winning and Hyderabad being such a sporting city? How does it feel?
Hyderabad is the capital of for badminton, and volleyball is also like played by most of the youngsters and all ages. We have in rural also we have most people playing the game. So we saw the potential, and when we we had meetings and all that, we thought volleyball is a sport where we can project ourselves and take it to the next level in the state of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. That's the reason we selected volleyball.
Fantastic, wonderful having the Black Hawks Hyderabad with us as well. And next up, Mr. Muthoot, just wonderful. Thank you for being here. Mr. Muthoot has very kindly agreed to come out here. He's not been keeping well, but he has come here just to show his support. Thank you, sir, so much for being out here, sir. And finally, sir, home team out here. And I mean, as I said, if you want to do anything in sport and you want to say that who is the person who can evaluate an opportunity and tell you whether this works or not, just ask the sharpest mind. He was the sharpest mind in the media business until he made so much money he didn't know what to do with it. That's not true. But I mean, at least he will not admit it's true. But one of the sharpest minds in the world of entertainment, now taking sport by storm from his Kabaddi team to what he's doing with his football academies, some very ambitious dreams, e-sports, there's so many there, but he's also come into volleyball. Ronnie, what brought you to volleyball?
Yeah, thank you everyone. We're really proud to be here on behalf of my co-founder, Supading, and myself. You know, I think what we revel in when it's sports, because we know India is a country that needs five national sports. We don't really have one. We need to take the other four to the next level. So I think that's what's been exciting us in the last 3-4 years. I think, to me, the pace of a game dictates how popular it can be, and I think this